today at the launch of Party for Animal Welfare, the world's brand new political party. It joins a worldwide movement of 20 really dynamic political parties for animals, some of whom have representation on city councils, in national parliaments, and in the European Parliament. As such, it should be seen as a really welcome and, in fact, essential addition to Irish political life. Animal welfare can and must be a priority at all levels of government, from the most local to the national and the global. Only this month, as Caroline's already referred to, I witnessed firsthand the sweeping changes for the better that can be made when animals are fairly represented in human politics. In the European Parliament in Strasbourg on the 14th of February, MEPs overwhelmingly voted to end long-distance animal transports from the EU to countries where animal welfare legislation doesn't match those of the EU. Time limits also were imposed on journey times for very young unweaned animals. So this vote in Strasbourg was a really resounding victory for animal welfare, and it is the shape of things to come. I wanted to mention animal transport specifically because Ireland, very sadly, is a major live exporter of farmed animals, including unweaned calves, sent on horrifically long journeys, as Caroline explained. So it's animals born here in Ireland who end up with little or no legal protection in countries where they're sent for fattening and slaughter. And we also have to think about transport of other animals used for so-called sport, so horses, greyhounds, the list goes on really. Last week's vote in Strasbourg came about because of coordinated efforts between NGOs and animal politics. Our Dutch counterparts, Party for the Animals, PVDD, have an incredible MEP, Anja Hazekamp, who sits on the Agri Committee in Brussels, where in this particular case, she worked to help effect huge change for 1.5 billion farmed animals who are moved long distances across Europe each year. So the vote can be seen as a really significant victory for animal politics. Nobody else would have prioritised this. I think that's the difference. Lots of politicians out there are in favour of, yeah, that's a bad thing, animal transport, but who prioritises it? Mm. It's up to us to speak for them. I also wanted to mention live exports to acknowledge the really difficult work done by Caroline and her colleagues. This country already has some very, very committed animal advocates, and the time's now come to bring it all together to make real political change for animals. Having a dynamic party for animal welfare in Ireland means that Irish animal charities, activist groups, and political representatives will be able to work together to smartly bring about lasting change. Even at the most local level, Ireland's local councils and their planning systems must take into account the impact of their decisions on the lives of all the animals who share this country, whether they're pigs, calves, hares, foxes, fish, dogs, the list goes on again. Every one of these animals we know here is a thinking, feeling, loving, fearing individual whose life is as important to them as ours is to us. There are animals in Ireland who are still reared in abject misery on factory farms, who are used in research laboratories, who are captive in zoos and aquaria, who are born into pet breeding facilities, hunted in the wild for so-called sport. The thing is, all of these activities take place on somebody's doorstep and under the watch of one local authority or another. All of them, bad as they are governed by laws that are enacted or kept at the national or international level. Unfortunately, animal exploitation is not going to end by us asking nicely. This is why real, sophisticated, focused representation around animal welfare is essential at the local, national, and international level. And this is why a party for animal welfare is sorely needed right here in Ireland. As it happens, tending to the welfare of animals through our political system is a win-win situation for all of us. Because as societies, we must judge ourselves by the way we treat the vulnerable and the voiceless, regardless of species. And by taking care of the rights and needs of the vulnerable, we actually enrich all of our lives. In animal politics, we're actually not trying to reinvent the wheel. We just want the world to be fairer for everyone. My colleagues here at Party for Animal Welfare believe in a better future for animals, but also for people and for the environment. And at Animal Welfare Party in the UK, we join with our 18 sister parties worldwide to offer you our ongoing friendship, solidarity and support. And I hope that many people across Ireland will add their compassionate voices to this movement for a better, fairer world. To my new colleagues at Party for Animal Welfare, we wish you great luck and courage. Represent well, represent wisely, and speak truth to power. They will listen in the end. Thank you. I've got a message from, loads of videos have come in just this morning from sister parties, which I'm sure you'll put on the Facebook page.
Yeah, so we had six videos arrived last night, for example. One very good one from the Party for Animals from Holland. A group of 20 people standing behind a banner, very enthusiastic, and they say, welcome, dear people in Ireland. Extremely enthusiastic. So I don't know if there's a way we can show some videos, if you like.
Well, I've got one came in from Cyprus, but in a message, so I need to read it out. This is from Kyriakos Kyriakou, brilliant name, love him, who's the president of Animal Party Cyprus. He says, dear friends, Animal Party Cyprus sends their best wishes and hopes for a better world protecting animal rights and our planet. The animal parties have to work together as a team, particularly now to work towards the challenge of the European elections. We wish you all the best. Keep up the great work for humans, animals, and environment. One health, one welfare, one world. Kyriakos Kyriakou, leader, Animal Party Cyprus. Mm-hmm. So yes, the other videos, I think if you put them online, people can see them. But,
yeah, if you give me a minute, maybe then.
It's probably better.
We've been campaigning for the last couple of years against factory farming, live export in particular, I was approached a while ago by Gerben, who wanted to start this party for animal welfare in Ireland, because there's nothing, when you look through all the manifestos of all the parties, like very few of them barely even mention animal welfare. It's just on paper there are rules and regulations in Ireland, but in practice they're just not, you know, they're not followed, they're not enforced. There's just so much going on with fur farming, greyhound racing, hare coursing. There's just so much cruelty in this country and neglect, and that's why we've started this party, to hope to actually get things to move forward, get this legislation changed, get it enforced. The majority of the Irish population are against blood sports, so why is it allowed to happen? Why are our taxpayers funding these industries that are just cruel, and they shouldn't still be going in the 21st century?
I'm the chairperson for the Party for Animal Welfare, which started on the 15th of December. We just won one single new thing where we've grown some interest. We got in touch with animal welfare groups, and we put it on the doorstep. If people are interested in animal welfare, and the fairmonts are, much more than we actually thought. From there, we were involved in a number of protests, including the one in Comel, basically against hair coursing. So from there on, we started to get the ball really rolling, and we established the Party for Animal Welfare in a very short period of time. We also were involved in a protest in Dunrati, basically that's in Clare, against fox hunting. And also in other issues like, for example, the horses. That horses are being neglected in a very bad way throughout Ireland in many areas, and there's not much control. and animal welfare officers are at this overstressed themselves.
Yeah.
So what we try to get across is that animals are getting the same appreciation as humans. And some people saying, are you then of the one issue party? No, we're not. We're a party for the planet, a party for the environment. So basically a party for everybody, where we would have the same dignity for animals as we would have for humans. Isn't that? That isn't too much to ask. That's a dream which could be materialized in a very simple way if everybody thinks equal.
I've come over here to support our colleagues at Party for Animal Welfare in Ireland. It's so exciting that they have a brand new party and the 20th animal party worldwide. They've got lots and lots of support from their sister parties overseas. We are one of them, but there are many others as well. I think in Ireland, the fact that we've got proportional representation, this fantastic political system, we're also in the EU, it's all to play for in terms of animal politics. People here know that when they vote, their vote counts. Unlike in the UK, where we're saddled with this horrible first-past-the-post system. So I think this is a brilliant use for Irish voters who are compassionate people who care about animal welfare. And it's not just about caring for animals. It's a win-win situation when you tend to the interests of animals and the environment. Those things are also good for humans as well. So combined, these are things that will really make Ireland a better place to live.